Hello everyone. In this video, I shall discuss about some approaches that has been adopted for special education. So let us see. Now, talking about inclusion, it implies that the students with and without disabilities are being included in the classroom. Okay, that is the normal term of inclusion. In this part, the institution takes into consideration that the general curriculum needs to be modified, keeping in view the need of the learners under the disability categories. Also, special services needs to be provided to the learners with disabilities, both within and outside the regular classroom. And these services will depend upon their needs and requirements. Okay, as we know, there are different sort of disabilities. The disabilities are not uniform. So depending upon the need of the learners, such services are being provided. With this, the learners who are being identified as disabled learners, they are made to attend some intensive training programs, okay, wherein they get some instructional sessions. In this way, they are made to attend these sort of sessions for developing or bring about some improvement in their learning behaviors. Okay, so whenever the need arises, this sort of programs are being arranged. Along with this, specialized equipments are need to be adopted by the respective institutions who intends to provide special education. As already discussed, there are various sort of disabilities. Okay, now take for example with regard to the speech and language pattern. The equipments should be based on this particular disability. Similarly, other disabilities, students having other disabilities, in the equipments are being provided or arranged for them. Is that clear? So coming to the next. Now, in case of mainstreaming, we find that basing on the skills of the learners, the students with special needs are made to be present or relate with the non-disabled students with respect to their process of education. Okay, this means that in certain specific time period, both the special needs child, that is the child with certain special needs, are made to relate with those non-disabled child in the process of education. In other words, this is a practice of educating both the learners of the different categories in some point of time. In this case, when a need arises, these sort of special need children's are allotted some special classes specifically meant to deal with these disabled children's. Okay, so this is the case of streaming the disabled child. So this is another approach for special education. Okay, it is like streaming the disabled child and providing them some special classes which are specifically meant for them. Okay, at first they are asked to relate with those who are not disabled, and later on when need arises they are being streamed out. Is that clear? So let's proceed with the next. So it is like segregating. This is what I have already stated. Now in the next case, that is segregation. Now see, this is segregation, and here one thing you have to remember is that both the disabled and non-disabled students are related. Okay, they are under the same roof. Only when need arises they are being segregated. Okay, they are being streamed out. This is something you have to remember here. Now in case of segregation, what happens is that the institution is meant specially for these special children's. Okay, we don't have the non-disabled children in this case. Okay, since it is specially meant for the disabled or the special need child, therefore they are being given special attention. Okay, they are given and they equally receive special attention because the institution is meant for handling those type of individual itself. In this way we find that this is definitely the instruction materials will exclusively be basing on their needs. Okay, so this is segregation. Now coming to the next part is exclusion. Now in this case, the students with special needs are being excluded from the schools. Now in a classroom setting, when the institution finds that there are some special children, so they try to exclude them from the school. sometimes, even in case of student being admitted, in the hospital for pretty long days or years, they are being excluded from the institution. And also in case of detainment, okay, when due to some criminal cases, cases under law. So even in this case, the students are being excluded from the school. Clear? But the case of suspension and expulsion, when the students are being expelled and suspended, that doesn't mean that it is a part of exclusion. Okay? That is not a part of exclusion. Is that clear? So you have this should not be mistaken. So suspension and being expelled are different cases. In exclusion means those students who are not coping up or not suiting the normal setup, they are being excluded. They are excluded because they have certain difficulties to learn, or they have certain deformalities. Okay, they have physical disorder, mental disorder, emotional disorder, as I have already spoken in my previous clippings, the videos. Okay, so this is all about exclusion. I hope it is clear. Okay, so let's switch over to the ways to improve instruction. It can be goal oriented. Okay, now how to improve the instruction? Instruction can be improved when it is goal directed. I hope that's clear. Now next is research based methods. Now in this case, instruction can be modified with the aid of research work, findings and all. Which method or which procedure can best suit the special need child? Clear? The next is guided by students' performance. How the students are performing, excelling, their weaknesses, their achievements. Basing on that, instructions can be modified. Okay? And certain new things can be added up to meet up with the learners. Then again, the next part is built up a collaboration with the special schools. Clear? I think these are clear. Now, next coming to this part, okay? That is co-teaching. Now, when we talk about co-teaching, it is a kind of setting wherein students with disabilities are placed in a general education classroom to learn along with their disabled peers or non-disabled peers. Okay? You can say a general education teacher and a special education teacher work as partners in instruction. Okay, the types of co-teaching includes, one teacher or one helping, in which one teacher instructs while the other, circulates around the class to evaluate and offer help. Clear? Is that clear? Now coming to the parallel teaching, you can say it is in which both teachers teach the same content. Okay? To two group of students of equal size. So when you say parallel, it can be understood that two equal, okay? It's equal, two equal groups of students are being handled by two teachers on the same content. Now, coming to the station teaching, okay, it is in which both teachers present different content to different group of students. Clear? I repeat, both teachers present differing content to different group of students simultaneously, and students rotate through each station. Okay, interesting. Now coming to alternative teaching, it implies in which one teacher works with a smaller group or individual students, while the other works with the rest of the class. Definitely by the term alternative, it can be understood it's altering. Now, coming to the team teaching, I've discussed this several times in my previous videos. Team teaching means what? In which both teacher plans and delivers the lesson in the same class, wherein an opportunity to handle each and every student is being focused. Clear? So that's the different, you know, ways to provide you can provide your lessons. Okay, is that clear? So let's switch to the other part of our discussion, that is, we have understood that how learning, how instruction needs to be provided, okay, by the respective institutions. But the fact cannot be denied that parents have a vital role to play. So let's have a look. Parents of which students, of whose student? Students, even if they are disabled students or not disabled students, feedbacks are very essential for the parents, isn't it so? Therefore, parents of students with learning disability, here the focus is on disabled students, definitely must be aware about their children, how their children are performing, what sort of disability they are facing, how to overcome them, where is the weakness like. So it gives an information to the parents as a whole. Therefore, parents has a great role to play in play, and therefore information about their students are very important. The institution therefore should should arrange for parent-teacher meet or invite the parents, have a discussion with them, so that they are aware about their child. Clear? So basing on what type of disability the student has, they can get access to accommodations like speech therapy, okay, the speech therapy, the occupational therapy, then adaptive physical education. Now by this, you must have well imagined, let me just tell you this, that once the teacher makes the parents aware about their child, then definitely the parents will be aware about their child's performance, their academic achievement, their other sort of achievement, scholastic, non-scholastic achievement. Where is the difficulty like? How it can be done, what it can be done to bring about, a basic improvement on their difficulties, to sort out the problems. So basing on those, some steps can be taken, at least for a step towards betterment. Therefore, parents have a great role to play. Their duty by sending them to the institution is not enough, but as a parent, they have to perform their the task like accepting their children and encouraging them, not making them feel low. That's a great role that the parent needs to play. So where are the difficulty and what sort of therapy it can be provided, learning about the skills of the learner, if they can be occupied in some occupational activities, okay, how it can be, improvement can be brought about. All those things can be taken into account, and that would be possible only if the parents have a word with the teacher, or teacher take an initiative to call the parents and discuss about the child. Clear? Now, not only parents, the community plays a greater role. So community awareness is also very important. Okay, so community awareness program, there should be posters and banners to bring about awareness, workshop and panel discussions on these areas. It can be taken up, how to sort out, how to develop the instructional strategies, how to develop teachers' potentialities to deal with these type of children. Again, collaboration with the medical teams, it's also very important. Encourage rehabilitation and counseling centers. All these are very important. It might sound simple, but it is very important. Thus, in this way, we see that education for special children are very important. They should be treated very well. They should be given an opportunity to learn and develop, since they will not be able to cope as the normal child. Therefore, special educational instructional materials should be developed specifically meant for them. Clear? In a way, we can say that, see, when we talk about disability and the difficulties they encounter, the different problems may arise. Okay? So, these are certain this chart which I have given, you can see the different type of disability. Can you see this? So, basing on these disability, they have this sort of difficulties. And having this sort of difficulties, it gives a rise to these sort of problems. Have a look at this and I'm sure you will understand. It's given out very clearly. So, in order to tackle this problem, special education is being taken into consideration. So, we as a teacher should develop the potentialities and skills that are actually desired, okay? Actually desired for helping the differently